Hello friends, welcome back to our channel anujindal.in. So in this video I am going to discuss some important questions from the topic input output. So this is an important topic in the reasoning section for your RBI grade B prelims. So in my previous video I have already covered 5 questions on input output. Now in this video I am going to cover further 5 questions. So in the previous video the level of difficulty was comparatively less, but in this video the question is comparatively tricky. So friends, if you like this video then do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that we get motivated to provide you with such further videos. So without wasting any time, let us start. So this is the question given to you, in which you are given an input and various steps of output. So you need to identify what is the pattern or what is the logic being applied in the various steps. So first of all, if you look at the input comprise of both words as well as numbers or digits. So there are numbers and there are words. So if you look at the input, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 words, and similarly there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 numbers. So there are 6 words and there are 6 numbers. And now if you analyze the various steps. So first of all, if we look at step 1. So in step 1, you will notice that 19 has been placed in the first position. But if you look at the input, input does not contain any number 19. Rather, input contains number 91. So you can see that in step 1, the number 91 has been reversed to 19. And also if you look at the input carefully, 91 is the largest among all the numbers. So 91 is the largest number among all the numbers. Then if you look at the rest of the words or numbers in step 1, so the position of rest of the words is unchanged, except if you look at the word B, the position of B has been changed. So B has been moved to the last. So 91 has been moved to the front and the digits are reversed, whereas the word B, it has been moved to the last. Now if you look at the word B and compare it with the other words of the input, you will notice the word B has the least number of letters. So the word B has least number of letters. So after analyzing only step 1, we are getting some hints that the largest number has been brought to the first position, whereas the word with the least number of letters has been brought to the last position. But we will analyze other steps also to be sure. So now we will look at step 2. So here you will notice that the number 47, it has been brought to the first position. But if you look at step 1 does not contain any number 47. Rather, step 1 contains the word 74. And again, if you look at the number 74, 74 is the largest number in step 1. So again, 74 has been brought to the first position in step 2 and the digits of 74 have been reversed. And if you look at rest of the numbers and words, their position is unchanged except the word but. So the word but, it has been brought to the last position after B. So but has been brought to the last position. And if you again analyze step 1, you will notice that the word but, it has the least number of letters 3 from among the remaining words. So B had the least number of letters 2 and next but has the least number of letters 3. And also if you glance at all the steps, you will notice that gradually all the numbers have been brought to the left, whereas all the words, they have been brought to the right. So the pattern is basically bringing the largest numbers to the first position and reversing their digits. And if we look at the words have been arranged from the least number of letters to the words having more number of letters, right? So the question reads, as per the rule followed which we have identified just now, find out the appropriate steps for the given input. So now we are given an input and we have to apply the same logic as I have just told you in this input, right? And this is the explanation of the logic which I just told you. So in the rearrangement, two elements are rearranged, which I told you, one word and one number. So in the first step, the highest number moves to the extreme left position and its digits are interchanged, while the word which contains least number of letters moves to the extreme right position. So the same procedure is continued till all the numbers and words get rearranged following the rule mentioned above. So this I have just shown you. Now let us see the input. Now we need to arrange this input into the desired output. So first of all, step one. So in the input, first of all, identify the largest number. So the largest number is 82. And we know we need to reverse the digits of this number. So 82 becomes 28. And if you look at the words, tire, toughen, tip, thanks, to, table. So from amongst these six words, identify the word with least number of letters. So the word 2 has the least number of letters. It has only 2 letters. So 2 will come in the last. So now let us arrange the words and numbers. So 28, it will be followed by tire, then 71, toughen, 59, tip, 13, thanks, 2 will go to the last, 68, table, 46, 2. So this is step 1. Now next, step 2. Now you have got the leftmost number and the rightmost word. So leaving aside these two, from the remaining 10 words and numbers, first of all, identify the largest number. So the largest number now is 71. So we have to place 71 in the leftmost position and we have to interchange the digits of 71. So 71 will become 17. So it will become 17 followed by 28. And if we look at the remaining words, so the word with the least number of letters is tip. Tip has 3 letters. So tip will move to the last. So 17, 28, tire, toughen, 59, 13, thanks, 68, table, 46, 2 and tip. So this is step 2. Now step 3. So from step 2, now you have got 2 numbers placed and 2 words placed. So you are left with 4 words and 4 numbers. So from the remaining 4 numbers, identify the largest number. So the largest number now is 68. So we will reverse the digits. So it will become 86 followed by 17 and 28. And from the remaining words, the word with the least number of letters is tire. Tire has 4 letters. So tire will move to the rightmost position. So 86, 17, 28, toughen, 59, 13, thanks, table, 46, 2, tip and tire. So we have got step 3. Now step 4. So we have got 3 numbers and 3 words. Now we are left with 3 words and 3 numbers. So from the remaining numbers, identify the largest number. So the largest number is 59. So reversing the digits, we will get 95 followed by 86, 17 and 28. And from the remaining words, the word table has the least number of letters, which is 5 letters. So table will move to the last. So after 28, toughen will come, then 13, thanks, 46, 2, tip, tire and finally table. So this is our step 4. So now we have got 4 numbers and 4 words. So we are left with 2 words and 2 numbers. So step 5. So from the remaining 2 numbers, 46 is the larger number. So reversing the digits, we will get 64 followed by 95, 86, 17, 28. And from the remaining these two words, toughen and thanks, the word thanks, it has lesser number of letters. So thanks has 6 letters, whereas toughen has 7 letters. So thanks will move to the rightmost position. So after 28, toughen, then 13, followed by 2, tip, tire, table, and finally thanks. So now we have got 5 numbers placed and 5 words placed. So now we are left with only toughen and 13. So now step 6. So 13 will move to the leftmost position. 13 will become 31, followed by 64, 95, 86, 17, 28. And toughen, it will move to the rightmost position. So 28, after 28, 2, tip, tire, table, thanks, and finally toughen. So we have got the final step, step 6. So this is the desired output. So we are getting the desired output in step 6. So now let us read the questions one by one. So we will keep referring to our output to get the answer, right? So question 6. In the last step, 1 is added to each of the odd numbers and 2 is subtracted from each of the even numbers. Then how many numbers multiple of 4 will be formed? So you have to add 1 to the odd numbers and subtract 2 from the even numbers and then see how many numbers are divisible by 4. So let us see the final step. So this was our final step, step 6. So our odd numbers are 31, 95 and 17 and our even numbers are 64, 86 and 28. So you have to add 1 to the odd numbers and subtract 2 from the even numbers. So 31 becomes 32, 64 becomes 62, 95 becomes 96, 86 becomes 84, 17 becomes 18 and 28 becomes 26. So you have got these 6 numbers. Now you have to see which among these numbers are divisible by 4. So 32 is divisible by 4, 62 is not divisible, 96 is again divisible, 84 is divisible by 4, 18 is not divisible and 26 is also not divisible by 4. So you can see 3 numbers out of 6, they are divisible by 4. So the correct option here is option B, 3 numbers, right? Now moving on to the next question, question 7. If in the step 3, 28 interchanges its position with table. So 28 has to interchange position with table and 59 interchange position with tip. So 59 will interchange position with tip. Then which of the element will be to the immediate left of 46? So after performing this interchange or swapping, we have to see which element will come to the left of, immediate left of 46. So if I refer to step 3 above, so I have just copied our step 3 which we calculated above. So if you look at this step 3, you have to interchange 28 with table and 59 with tip. So after performing the interchange, step 3 will become like this. So 86, 17, so here table will come, then tough one. So in place of 59, tip will come, then 13, thanks. In place of table, 28 will come, then 46, 2. In place of tip, 59 will come and finally tire. So now if you look at this step 3, so you have to find which element will be to the immediate left of 46. So this is 46, so 28 lies to the immediate left of 46. So the correct answer is option A, 28. Now next, question 8. Which of the following combinations represent the third and the ninth element in second last step of the given input from the left end? So second last step was our fifth step and you have to find out the third and the ninth element in the fifth step and these elements should be from the left end. So this is right end and this is left end. So from the left end. So let us see our step 5. So if you look at the step 5, you have to see the third element and the ninth element from the left end. So third element is 86 and ninth element is tip. So third element is 86 and ninth element is tip. So the correct option is option D, 86 and tip. Now moving on to the next question, question 9. Which element comes exactly between 59 and thanks in step 2? So you have to see step 2. So in step 2, you have to see which element comes in between 59 and thanks. So let us refer to step 2. So in step 2, you can notice that 59 lies here and thanks lie here. So you can see 13, it lies between 59 and thanks in step 2. So the correct option will be option C, 13. Now moving on to the last question, final question, question 10. Which element is third to the right of the one which is eighth from the right end in step 4? So this is somewhat tricky question. You have to break down the question. So the question is saying, first of all, you have to see step 4. Now it is saying which element is third to the right of the one which is eighth from the right end. So you have right end and left end, they are saying there is an element which is 8th from the right end. So there must be an element which is 8th from the right end. You have to find the element which is 3rd to the right of this element, which means the element 5th from the right end. So you have to find out the element which is 5th from the right end, because this element will be 3rd to the right of 8th element, right? So let us go to our step 4. So this is our step 4. So we have to see the 5th element from the right. So if we look at step 4, 5th element from the right is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 46, it is the 5th element from the right end, and it is also 3rd to the right of 8th element. The 8th element is Tuffen. So 46 is 3rd to the right of Tuffen. So the correct answer will be 46. So the correct answer is option E, 46. So friends, this was a pretty tricky question. So these types of questions are generally asked in your RBI Grade B prelims. So this is an important topic, input output. I have tried to explain you this topic in a simple manner so that you can solve these questions easily. So you can refer to my earlier video on this same topic, in which I have covered 5 questions. Also, you can refer to my other videos in which I have covered other topics for your reasoning, like directions, ranking, etc. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. All the best for your RBI Grade B prelims. Have a nice day.